Sometimes I wonder, is anyone listening to me? I bet they would not even notice I'm singing off key. I could say something completely outrageous, and they'd never know. Yeah. Like virtuosic, contrapunto, lipstick, hootie and the blowfish.
See, I told you they weren't listening.
Please.
converted, but I have no idea that it's like, you know, somebody else. So I'd get away with some of those. Yeah, I wrote this song when I was nine.
Explain what Here to Heal is about.
Last spring, I went to my daughter's choir performance and saw the show. Thought, man, there's got to be a way that we can bring this show to the masses. You know, came up with this idea. Let's talk to the kids. You know, how can they participate in the show? Not just dictate to them what the show is. Let them tell us what they want to talk about. So we sat down with them and we went through several interviews and came up with hundreds of ideas that these kids had. And took those ideas and we went back and sat down and came up with a script. And came up with an idea of, okay, how can these kids get their message out to the world? And that's where Here to Heal came from. Hold on, hold on. Darling, hold on, hold on.
It was just great to get in front of the students and talk to them and write down, you know, what was on their mind, and then to come up with songs around that to help them to express themselves. But I think the response was really, really good.
I think so, and especially this being the very first school we talked to.
Yeah,
I mean, we didn't know what we were walking into.
Right, and we still don't.
Well, the cool thing is, I think, you know, the original concept was that this was going to be based on existing music. There are original tunes written for this project based completely on the response we got back from the kids.
Yeah.
From, I mean, some of this stuff, the lyrics are almost verbatim what the responses were to questions. And I think that's pretty cool.
Especially one call, you could tell that there was a lot on their minds that they really wanted to talk about, and they were just waiting for somebody to ask the question.
You had 1 minute to live, and you wanted to reach out to someone. Who would you call? Who would you call? What would you say? What would you say? There was something that was on your mind. Tell them who would you call, who would you call? What would you say, what would you say? You just had 1 minute to live. If you wanted to reach out to someone, who would you call, who would you call? What would you say, what would you say? If there was something that was on your mind, and you didn't have the words to tell them, who would you call, who would you call? What would you say, what would you say?
There's so many beautiful aspects to it. I mean, one, just the healing aspect.
Yes.
You know, and talking to the kids, a lot of it was kind of therapeutic in a way.
For all of us.
For all of us, it really was. It's to create even more communication between the students and their parents, the students and the teachers, the students and the counselors, and the students within each other. And what we found out was something very interesting in speaking with them, the topics that were on their minds, the dilemmas, the problems that they wanted to talk about, you know, were a little bit off than what we than what we originally thought. And we all got kids, and you know, we think we know what's on their mind, but you know,
I'm finding out that that's not the case.
Right.
With this, honestly.
Exactly. Yeah. With it again, like you said, this is therapeutic for all of us. You know, it's opened up a whole new door of a learning process and a different chapter in our lives, and helping to really connect with teenagers, young adults. In 2012.
So this was going to give them a chance to really be part of something as opposed to just playing along.
Something that they can create.
Again, the door is wide open. However creative you want to get.
First meeting, we were just kind of...
winging it.
We were winging it. We really were. You know, you come in with an idea and you're going to present it to, you know, the teachers and the students, and, you know, you don't know if they're going to like it, if they're not going to like it, if they're going to be into it or not. But, you know, when you have a good idea, which we think we have a good idea, you just, okay, we're going to go in there with that confidence. It's one of those things where, okay, I think I got something really good. And when somebody validates it that doesn't know you, that have no reason to say, oh, it's great, you know, they look at it, and especially from his father's point of view, who was in this every day,
right.
And she was like, I get this.
It's easy to stand back and think, what's your idea? You see the picture and you get it.
Right.
But when somebody else joins in your vision.
When you're writing for an album, there's always, you know, the powers that be are trying to get you to gear it into this avenue that leads to radio or video or the masses. I believe that love is the answer. I believe that love will find a way. But with this, you know, we take the ideas of the students and just write songs about that. And I'm not worried about how long the intro is, and I'm not worried about how long it takes to get to the chorus. I'm just trying to express the point. And when it's done, it's done. And if it's a 5-minute song, then it's a 5-minute song. If it's a 9-minute song, then it's a 9-minute song. If it's 2 minutes, whatever. It wasn't that hard. The ideas were right in front of me.
Yeah, and you go in and you talk to the kids, and they basically lay it right there. And it's... It writes itself.
It writes itself. Yeah.
But when you experience the emotion and everything that they have, it's there.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Is a chance to make tomorrow better.
I believe there is no such thing as color of skin.
I believe in forgiveness. You aren't who you were yesterday.
I believe one day I'll make a difference in someone's life.
I believe insecurities ruin a person. You're all beautiful no matter what society tells you.
I believe that from harsh endings come new beginnings.
I believe I am who I call myself, and not what others call me.
I believe that I don't always have to be perfect.
I believe in the power of family.
I believe that anything I want to be, I can be.
I believe that through faith in God, anything can happen.
I believe that we can be the change we want to see in the world.
I believe that music connects us all.
I believe in myself.
blindly to the light and reach out for his hand. Don't ask any questions and don't try to understand. Open up your mind and then open up your heart. And you will see you and me aren't very far apart. 'Cause I believe that love is the answer. I believe love will find a way. Violence is spread worldwide and there are families on the street. And we sell drugs to children now. Why can't we just see that all we do is eliminate our future with the things we do today? But money is our incentive now, so that makes it okay. But I believe that love is the answer.
All you can remember are the words you use the most.
breakup, and I was singing it to her like, no, truly, it's not the end of the world. He's just a guy. Get over it. You know what I mean? You guys, come on. We've been there, right?
Let the lion leave, the lion sing, the word is together, the we and the weather. He said a lot of things, I'm sure he meant them out.
It's the end of the world. It's not the end.
Spend half the time dreaming, the other half's a lie. You don't know where you're going and you don't know how to try. You don't really have a best friend, but you think that you're alone. Now all you can remember are all the words you use the most. Like the lie and believe, the eye and deceive, the her and together, the we and the weather. He said a lot of things, I'm sure he meant them at the time, but it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world. Well, you did see it coming, but you never understood. But there's a time to draw the line when things aren't going good. But you just kept on giving, you want to call alone. And he was kind to rob you blind of the pieces of your heart. Like the part that made you beautiful and the part that made you weak. When he would softly kiss you and tell you that he missed you, I know it doesn't seem right, but I'm gonna say it's true. But it's not the end of the world. I say it's not the end of the line, 'cause you know there's more to love. You have to win this fight.
I just wish that I could hold you and tell you it's alright, but it's not the end of the world.
In an email, they asked if I would be interested in doing some of the music. It was Brian Halsey, who was their manager. And I knew Brian because he was a parent of some of my students. So I responded to his email and said, told him that I couldn't promise anything, but I certainly was interested in hearing his proposal. So one afternoon after school, I was sitting in my office doing some work about 4 o'clock, and Eliot Sloan walked in and introduced himself to me, and we started talking, and the idea came out of there.
It was just really cool when the band came, because they made us understand that there are people and adults that understand our problems as teenagers, and they were willing to take time out of their busy schedule to come work with us and put on this concert.
We had outside input from Eliot, and then we also allowed the students to have a lot of input in talking about the themes of the concert.
Clearly, as a student, usually the teachers are the ones who just make up the concert plan. So it was really cool to actually have some input for the once in the concert and get to decide what we did and how we did it. And I think it actually sounded pretty cool.
We gave them lots of discussion time in small groups where they came up with ideas of ways to present the songs. So they really had a very key role in this concert, and generally that's not what we do.
We actually had a purpose to this concert. It wasn't just us going through the same old steps that we usually do, just, you know, the old routine. This concert really had a purpose, and it had a deep message to it, and that was really important to all of us.
Some of them actually went out online to YouTube and listened to some of the songs that they were working on. So when we came back after fall break, we spent every minute of every class period preparing and just changing ideas and deleting things and adding things. And Eliot was here with us a good bit that week and helped us make decisions. It was also nice to see students who normally don't become involved in anything, and they raised their hand and offered suggestions and input in this concert.
So we worked really hard together, and I mean, we pulled it together, and it was an overall great experience. It's definitely something that I couldn't have experienced anywhere else with anyone else.
She don't care about my car, and she don't care about my money, and that's real good, cause I don't got a lot to spend, but if I did, it wouldn't mean nothing. She likes me for me, not because I look like Thompson Bedford with the charm of Robert Redford oozing out my ears. But what she sees are my outstanding decisions, my insecure condition, and the tears of blood on the pillow that I shed. She don't care about my big screen or my collection of DVDs. Things like that just never mattered much to her. But she don't watch too much TV, and she don't care that I can buy her to places she ain't never been. But if she really wants to go, I think deep down she knows that all she has to say is when. She likes me for me, not because I hang with Leonardo or that guy who played in Fargo. I think his name is Steve. She's the one for me, and I just can't live without her. My arms belong around her, and I'm so glad I found her once again. Yeah, I'm so glad I found her once again. Yeah, I'm so glad I found her once again. Me for me, not because I seem like paparazzi or because I'm such a hottie. I like her for her, not because she's fat like Cindy Crawford. She has got so much to offer. Why does she waste all her time with me? There must be something there that I don't see. I don't see. She likes me for me. Not because I'm tough like Debbie Harry, make her laugh just like Jim Carrey. I'm like a cable guy. And what she sees is that I can't live without her. My arms belong around her, and I'm so glad I found her once again. I found her once again. Once again.
Down this hallway.
Nice.
For everybody.
Nice.
So, okay, to Brownsburg High School. So we will present this, and we'll have it up by the stage. Tonight's a great night. Brainchild of this man and this guy. And we are honored. Humbled and great to have two great friends to be doing this with. To hear 400 or 500 teenagers singing songs, you know, that came from our hearts is a priceless feeling. And we hope people are moved by all this. And we hope this is just the beginning of something great that's going to last for a long, long time. You know, there's always going to be teenagers, there's always going to be schools, there's always going to be pain and difficulty, and we hope here to heal. Continue to hear to heal kids, all of us. Yeah, this has been a healing process for all of us. You know what I mean? It's not just for the kids. Everybody's learning something. There's something to be discovered with everything that we're doing. So it's just an honor to be a part of it. We thank Brownsburg High School for being the first. Thank you, Brownsburg.
All right, lead and freshmen, please move to the multi-purpose area.
each and every one of us, boy or girl, freshman or senior, everyone counts. For the past few weeks, everyone on this stage has put effort forth to reach out. We are reaching out to help and encourage our peers. We are the light, the hope, and the encouragement for this generation and for future generations. We will seek healing. We believe love will find a way. Can you hear us now?
To pray for things that I don't need, trouble God with all my vanities. I used to pray for things that I shouldn't want. I meant to say thanks, but I forgot. But now I'm praying for healing. I pray for peace. I pray for healing for you and me. I used to pray that all my bills got paid, and that we got safely to the shores that we played. I used to pray that we'd get MTV, so we could get where we thought we should be. But now I pray for healing. I pray for peace. I pray for healing. I used to pray my kids would grow up happy. Now I pray that they grow up at all. But I refuse to let these fears devour me, 'cause you know it won't be long before we're standing taller. I used to pray when I had the time, but now I find myself praying all the time. And all the things that I used to pray for suddenly don't mean anything no more, 'cause now I pray for healing.
can you bring the music down just a little bit? Can you turn the mountain music down? Just keep it low. This is something totally at the last minute. Bring it down a little bit more for me, please. I didn't tell Ms. Stainbrook about this. I talked to Ms. Prather. My name is Eliot Sloan. I'm with the band Blessid Union of Souls, and this is this. This is a dream come true for myself and my two colleagues. They're probably out in the lobby. Brian Halsey, who came up with this whole idea for Here to Heal earlier this year. And here we are less than a year later. And look at this. also his brother-in-law, my friend Kevin Kinder. I wish they could be up here on stage with me because I'm about to do something that involves both of them, and it also involves Melissa Stainbrook and Debbie Prather. If I could have Melissa and Debbie come up on stage, that would be a beautiful thing. You know, this, goodness gracious, this would not be possible without their talents and hard work. I remember Brian and I was, is Brian and Kevin around? They're so humble, they didn't even want their name on the program. Speaking with Ms. Prather and Melissa about it about 7-8 months ago, and they jumped right on board with this idea. And we didn't know how it was going to go, and, you know, are they going to like this idea? They jumped right in with both feet, and this production would not be even remotely possible without their hard work, hours, and all these children. I don't mean to call you children, but kids. I'm in my 40s. You're all children to me. I'm sorry. All these kids. So because this is the first school that we're going to do this, we plan to do this for years to come, Here to Heal. I'd like to dedicate this guitar to Brownsburg High School. It's one of the first guitars that I've ever had. And it basically says the Brownsburg High School, Here to Heal, and that's what we're here to do. So I want you two to have this and hang it up in the, what did you call it, the display case? What did you call it, the living room of the hallway? Listen, for all you kids, I know you're not kids, you're young adults. And the parents, God bless you all. Thank you so much. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to break down on you guys, but this is just huge for me. And I love you all. Thank you so much. God bless. Have a great night. Thank you. Thank you very much. Play the music now. Thank you and good night.
Moments like that just, they're priceless, you know?
you take piano lessons, you play guitar, you play in bands, and you stay in it just for that moment sometimes, you know what I mean? And nothing else matters, you that moment and reaching that many people. The best moment, I mean, there were a lot of great moments. I think the culmination of things when we did Healing and all the kids are lined up and the parents are there watching and the long standing, like, wow, it just felt like we just witnessed something that was really, really special. That's kind of like what I got from the last ovation of it. The songs would not have been born if we didn't come and talk to the students and write those ideas down, which is why it's really cool you put that inside of the CD.
Yeah.
It's like, this is where it came from, you know?
I've watched you perform many, many times, and they've all been great shows, but there was something that I saw in you tonight that was, it was more than a show.
I was thoroughly moved. You know, how can you not be moved? You turn around and see, you know, 200-300 students behind you and singing you. I mean, some of these songs were written in a little studio in Cincinnati with an idea that, oh man, this might be a good song. You said that from day one, Healing should be the last song. And I was like, okay. And not that I wasn't for it or not, I was, you know, playing in the band, you always want to end up with that high, you know, impact, up-tempo song. But Healing was the perfect closing because it was the ultimate message.
It was Healing.
I mean, we've learned a lot. Yeah. We're going to continue to learn a lot from it.
Yeah, I didn't come into this thinking I was going to learn anything. I'm amazed at how much this has opened my eyes.
Yeah.
And you never think of a high school would have that much depth, that much raw emotion. Yeah. You know, I was in high school.
Right, right.
And you didn't have that much depth.
I didn't.
So Brian was very shallow.
Apparently I was. But it's been an amazing process.
Yes.
From beginning to end.
We pictured kind of like this, like, you know, with the theme.
Well, you picture it like this, but you don't know that it's going to turn out like that. You know what I mean? Like, I was standing out in the audience and just hearing the response and everything was really cool.
Yeah, so you guys got to hear that side
yeah.
of it.
Yes, oh, absolutely. Yeah. And it's a completely different response than, you know, when you're up here. I really enjoyed being on that side of it. Well, but yeah, yeah, one girl came up to me and she's like, are you that one guy? I'm like, yeah.
Could you
sign my CD? I'm like, yeah, I can, but I don't really sign anything. So yeah. I signed right over your name. I sharpied you out.
We were just like, man, this is the first school. I want to do something special for them. Trust me, we're not giving away the cards for sure. Yeah, but we knew we wanted to do something special, and Brian had the idea of giving a guitar, and I was like, well, I think this guitar that in my studio that I used to play all the time, I don't really play it that much. And then, to be honest with you, when he saw it, he was like, you sure you want to give that guitar? I was like, no, I absolutely do. Because I wanted to give something that really meant a lot to me. That, not for lack of a better term, you know, it hurt to give away. But something, not just like, oh, here, I never use this or use that. No, I wanted to give something that was special. And that was a special guitar. It was one of the first guitars I ever had. And the kids had no idea.
No.
And I don't think Miss Steinberg had any idea. Miss Prather did. Yeah, that was really nice. That was really nice. We wanted to do something special. They were the first class to do it. And I think that was a really special moment.
Did you actually see the kids? Not tonight, but the whole process. Because, you know, when we first talked to them, there's kids who were breaking down crying when they were opening their hearts. Because we asked them from the very beginning, what do you want to talk about? And there are some kids that broke down. I mean, crying. From the heart, not just tears.
Kids that came up to us afterwards and handed us poems that they had written or shared stories that they wouldn't even tell their parents.
Yeah.
Maybe I shouldn't say that, but things that they shared with us that make you realize that that's what this is all about.
So yeah, the amazing thing is the kids, they did this all week.
And we're dealing with this many kids and, you know, not everybody's going to like the same genre of music, not everybody can dance. But they all pulled it together, you know what I mean? That's what I was one thing I was really proud of, because, you know, you're talking to 200-300 students and trying to get everybody somewhat on the same page with this set of songs, they did beautiful.
Won't you let me?
me catch a fall. Won't you let me lend a hand? Those lonely eyes have seen it all. But love's too blind to understand, 'cause you don't know what you have till you're everything.